understanding reckon the number of the beast.
For it is a few.
Its number is 666.
What did I see? Can I believe? stage here. Really nice to throw this in the dark when we can't see it, alright? Not. Because if you're going to throw shit, you know, just why don't you take the guy next door to you and you try throwing a beer bottle at him and you wait and see what the reaction is and you'll get some kind of idea what we think about it, alright? Even if they are plastic. Thank you very much. How the fuck are you anyway, Tendra? Fiddler's Green. What a strange motley crew we are here this evening. I'm not talking about the band. Oh dear, it's all kicking off, isn't it, this evening? Well, we're going to play you all kinds of songs from the past, from the present, and indeed one song from the future, because we've got a new album coming out. So without further ado, oh for fuck's sake, there's some guy doing WrestleMania down here. I should be told. Or maybe it's transvestite WrestleMania, I don't know, shit. Oh maybe not. Is it a he? Is it a she? Oh, it's an it. Okay. Off to the vomitorium with you then.
I can't fucking hear you!
For a 25-year-old band, I see quite a few people out there who, you know, maybe haven't seen this band before. I mean, but you know what the end of music as we know it is? The end of music as we know it is fucking corporate sponsorship of rock and roll bands. It's radio stations and music video stations. All they care about is the mighty fucking advertising dollar, and they don't give a fuck about new music, they don't give a fuck about new bands, they don't give a shit about people who have honesty and integrity in their music, and neither do the major labels, which is why they're trying to blame the audience for the shit that they've got themselves into, signing a load of fucking weenie bands with only two good songs in their head that sound like every other fucking band that they sign. Why isn't anybody buying the record? Why is everybody getting it for free? Because it's not worth fucking buying, because the band's going to be chopped in 2 years. Yeah. Anyway, the point is, you're here. And because you're here, we're here. Simple as that, alright? So, the album's called Dance of Death. It's out in a couple of weeks. We're going to play you a tune from it now. This one's called Wildest Dreams! Alright!
Come on.
battery in this torch. You don't know what happens to you. Never mind. Right. I want to tell you a story. not that story. Now, I'll tell you a different story. Ever heard of a place called Scotland? Anybody? Anybody know where it is? Well, that's a third of you think if you know where Scotland is, and about the same number reckon you've heard of it, so that's good. Anybody ever heard of a movie called Braveheart? Slightly better. Anybody ever heard of a bloke called Mel Gibson? Even less, okay, very good. Where have you been, all you people? Never mind. Anyway, this is a movie, this is a story, not about a movie, not about Mel Gibson. It's about a real guy called William Wallace, who fought the big bad English in Scotland when they tried to steal a lot of things that actually didn't really belong to them, like land and things like that. And so we wrote a song about it, which we thought you might like to hear. Some of you may not even know this song. Well, that's just fucking tough shit. It's called The Clansman.
Yeah.
big as the fucking eye.
crew, now you're strolling through the park. When the light begins to fade, sometimes feel a little strange in Denver in the dark. The dark. I have a constant fear that something's always near. Fear of the dark. Hey, you! I have a phobia that someone's always there. Thank you.
Scream Tommy Denver! Scream Tommy Denver! Ooh. Oh! Don't titter, titter ye not. How are you anyway? We thought we'd come out and surprise you, you see, because we know what happens here. We know the ritual where we hide backstage and pretend, and you pretend that you have to say, we want more before we come out, you see. But you know that we're going to come back out, and we know that we're going to come back out. So we all hide back there and drink cups of tea, you see, and playing chess and intellectual pursuits, sort of thing that we get up to on stage. Sort of thing I'm sure you get up to as well, never mind. Anyway, how the hell are you? Have you enjoyed yourselves this evening? This is a good thing. This is a very good thing. Very good thing. We're very pleased about that. Let me introduce you to some of my partners in crime up here. Over here on the guitar, Mr. Yannick Gers. Also on the guitar, standing over here, Mr. Dave Murray. Several cows died for this man's trousers, Mr. Adrian Smith! Then of course there is the madman of Jones Beach. They couldn't hold him in the Rock, they couldn't hold him in San Quentin! Sentenced to life without parole! Serving with Iron Maiden on the road, Mr. Nick Abbott Brain on the drum! Last but not least, of course, Mr. Steve Harris over here on the bass guitar. Woo! You'll know the answer to this question. Yes, you. You in the Iron Maiden shirt. Yes, the West Ham shirt too. What's the time? What?